G. Narayanamma Institute of Technology and Science for Women, well known as GNETS, was started in the year 1997 by the eminent entrepreneur and philanthropist Sri G. Pulareddy. The institute, named after his beloved wife, Srimati G. Narayanamma, is envisioned to leverage education as a means of empowerment of women. Sri G. Pulareddy, known for his uncompromising quality and vision, with his deep concern and strong conviction for the welfare of the society, established G. Pulareddy Charities Trust in 1977. That sponsors and manages several public service institutions, educational institutions, respite homes, orphanages, and organizations that uphold the Indian culture, tradition, and values.
The vision of GNETS is to empower women in technical education. That is why Sri G. Pulareddy Garu started this exclusive women's college, first of its kind in Andhra Pradesh, in the year 1997. Over a period of time, our college has occupied the top position among all the engineering colleges in the state, and it is a dream of the many girl students all over Andhra Pradesh to secure admission in this prestigious institution, those who are aspiring for technical education. The immediate vision is to go for deemed university, first of its kind for women exclusively in the state of Andhra Pradesh.
Located at Sheikhpet, Hyderabad, GNETS is tucked away from the hustle bustle of the city congestion and chaos. The 12.5 acres of campus with well-demarcated buildings is remarkable, with shaded tree-lined avenues with lush green lawns, aesthetic landscaping and gardens of lively floral spread that sets an ideal ambience for professional learning. GNETS maintains state-of-the-art infrastructure with modern academic buildings, Wi-Fi enabled campus, sophisticated labs, finest library block, high-end hostel facilities, well-maintained transportation and games and sports facilities, with a centrally located captivating Sri G. Pulareddy Memorial provides an ideal environment for a congenial learning experience.
Narayanamma College, our USP basically, along with being centrally located in the Hyderabad city, also is that we adopt modern technology, modern teaching standards, but we also try to preserve our culture and the traditions in the campus.
When I look back to the day that I got the admit, I feel that is the best day of my life so far. I hope that this institute emerges as the number one institute in Andhra Pradesh in coming years.
GNETS offers 4 years full-time BTech degree programs in the branches of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, EEE, Electronics and Communication Engineering, ECE, Electronics and Telematics Engineering, ETM, Computer Science and Engineering, CSE, Information Technology, IT, and 2 years M.Tech program in Power Electronics and Electric Drives in EEE again, Computer Science and Engineering in CSE, Digital Electronics and Communication Systems in ECE, Wireless and Mobile Communications in ETM, Computer Networks and Information Security in IT. Each department is headed by well-qualified professors who have extensive, enriching experience in teaching, research, as well as industrial know-how, supported by highly dedicated faculty members. GNETS strength is a reflection of their skills, innovation, and drive. The awards bestowed upon the elite faculty of GNETS explains the pedagogy of excellence.
We are having 172 highly qualified and most experienced teaching staff, supported by 95 non-teaching staff. Indian Society for Technical Education, totally known as ISTE, has declared our institution as the best engineering college of Andhra Pradesh. Then I myself declared as the best principal among the 730 engineering colleges of Andhra Pradesh. We have excellent staff, mainly Dr. Ramesh Reddy, head of EEE department, is awarded as the best electrical engineering teacher among all the engineering colleges of the state. Similarly, Dr. Venugopal Rao, head of CSC department, declared as the best computer science teacher among the 730 colleges in the year 2013 December. we are happy to note that more than 100 research papers are being produced by our teaching staff, and about 85 research papers are produced by our postgraduate and undergraduate students regularly.
The five main department laboratories are well maintained, spacious, and equipped with latest software and engineering. The labs are upgraded with the latest software every year. Well-ventilated, spacious classrooms are the hub for stimulating teacher-student interactions.
It has actually transformed me from one phase of my life to the other. Presently, I am a well-built, confident girl. So I am out of the college. So that is how the transformation has begun from my college. And also, the faculty in my college are wonderful. They are highly qualified, well-teaching staff in my college, especially in my department too. So my college is the best place any person can study their engineering.
Besides the core engineering branches, Department of Humanities and Mathematics and the Department of Basic Sciences, the Mechanical and the Examination branch play a pivotal role in establishing and facilitating the students to cope up with the expectations and challenges of the professional courses. Apart from the various splendid labs, the Center for English Language Learning, known as CEL, facilitates to improve the soft skills and communication skills of the students of all the years. The research and development wing of the institute promotes and encourages the collaborative works of the staff and the students towards path-breaking innovations and research. The R&D's incubation center is a grooming ground for many research works and experimentation. The center provides support functions, mentorship, and resources to individual students for entrepreneurial setups. Britex Biophotonics, also known as BTBP, the offshoot of R&D wing, is another collaborative research work initiated by the institute that deals with skin analysis and measurements powered by BTBP's artificial intelligence engine and image processing. Apart from the in-campus hostel facility, the institute has two well-furnished cafeterias that provide tasty food and beverages for the students as well as the staff members. The tuck shops provide a casual and relaxed environment to hang out. The food menu, designed to be shared amongst friends in a contemporary, locally inspired space and environment. The institute is semi-residential and hostel accommodation is provided to students coming from other parts of the country. Genits has fully furnished two multi-story hostel buildings within the campus to accommodate 750 students. Each building provides air-conditioned rooms as well as non-air-conditioned rooms with all modern amenities like Wi-Fi facility, solar water heating systems, healthcare, general stores, etc. The ever-caring wardens and round-the-clock security personnel ensure students' safety and security. The hygiene kitchen and the spacious dining hall cater vegetarian, nutritious food for both South Indian and North Indian students. A double-story library at GNITS is a gateway to knowledge resources. The library is fully automated, equipped with spacious reading halls, internet and e-learning resources, and reprographic facility, apart from a large area for stocking of books. Apart from the magnificent library, the institute also facilitates the students with internet browsing center for study reference and knowing the ongoing trends and technological advancements of the world. A vast area is earmarked in the campus for sports and games. The institute has on its rolls physical director, several trainers and other supporting staff. Facilities for the following outdoor games and sports are available, like basketball, volleyball, throwball, coco, handball, athletics, etc. The institute maintains excellent facilities also for indoor games. This badminton court is fully adorned with wooden flooring for a perfect playing experience. Table tennis, chess and carom rooms are also provided with same comforts. It also encourages the students to take active participation in gymnasium and other activities. GNITS winning the overall championship in sports under JNTUH speaks volumes about sportsmanship of the college.
And I'm proud to say that today GNH is number one as far as sports is concerned, and we are all the JNTU champions in the girls category the past 7 years. And many of our students, they played at the national level and the state level, and they've been representing the JNTU in the All India University levels. So not only competition oriented fitness, here we inculcate them all the health related fitness programs also, like yoga, meditation and all, which is really relevant and important for them to relieve their stress.
The college is well connected with 17 buses. Student counseling is one of the hallmarks of the institution. JNIT's NSS unit, National Service Scheme, aims at arousing social consciousness. Various activities like blood donation camps, health camps, special camps visiting downtrodden areas, pulse polio camps are few among the many other social and community relevant activities taken up by the NSS unit in collaboration with JNTU Hyderabad. A single source of comprehensive information about all the vibrant academic, literary, cultural, sports activities of the college are made available in JNIT's newsletter Sanketika Bharati. JNIT has a full-fledged training and placement cell headed by a HR manager of Professor Kader. The placement cell provides the required pre-placement training programs periodically in consultation with various recruiting firms, companies, facilitating the students to equip with the employability skills ready for industrial jobs. In addition, the cell also organizes alumni association meet on first Saturday of January every year.
GNIT has been attracting tier 1 companies right from its very first final year coming out. Actually, all the major tier 1 companies like JP Morgan, Deloitte, Accenture, Infosys, so many companies have been coming with a package of 7.1 lakhs per annum being the highest, and a minimum of 3 lakhs is being the minimum salary package. It's been very, very encouraging for GNITs to get the students placed in top-notch companies, and the companies have really have given a very good feedback, and that's the reason why year after year the placements have been increasing. Deloitte has publicly voiced the opinion about the GNITs students and has taken 29, which is one of the highest numbers in AP this year.
I basically hail from the state of Jharkhand. Well, this college has given me a lot of scope for development, and now I can completely say that yes, I am a true JNITian, and I have actually excelled a lot, and what I was in first year and what I am now is completely different. It has given me a transition from being a very simple and a very down-to-earth girl to a more confident and a more evolved girl.
Today, JNITS is the most sought-after engineering institute for many aspirants. The distinct achievements of JNITS is a trendsetter for many educational institutions, and this wouldn't have been possible without the unstinted patronage by the management, proactive support by the director, continuous nurturing and mentoring by the dedicated faculty and ever-enthusiastic students. JNIT stands one among the many engineering colleges in the state for its quality technical education to enable the women engineering graduates to excel in their chosen careers. The women engineering graduates of JNIT stand empowered, fulfilling the vision and the mission of the institution to be a part of the workforce for nation building.